How is it going, my good friends? So in this video it's gonna be a little bit different, a little bit more explaining and showing what I'm doing when it comes to engraving. So it will be kind of three parts, where the first part I'm going to make two gravers in two different styles. I wouldn't say styles, two different methods, maybe two different materials. And after that we're gonna do some scroll design, and lastly we're gonna do the engraving themselves. So I hope you like this one, and yeah, let's start with the stuff. Alright, so for the engraving chisels we're going to use, I have this piece of high-speed steel that I've ordered online. These are pretty cheap, and I've already, as you see, cut it off, so I just annealed it, and so it didn't came this way. I just heat it up so I can cut it, because it's too hard for the saws. So we have that, and this is this is what we're going to use for the square engraver or chisel. And I have a spring steel, a round stock spring steel, which I'm going to use for the onglet engraver, which is, I will show you. So, just to make things a little bit clearer of what I'm going to do, I'm gonna illustrate it. So the square graver is something along these lines. I hope this is obvious. This is the square, obviously. Now if you see it from a side view, it looks something like that. And the angle of the face should be around between 40 degrees to 50 degrees. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna put the graver in this orientation to sharpen it, and this would be our angle. And I'm gonna do 40 degrees as I've drawn here. For this one thing is pretty darn crucial, is to have a small honing guide. These are very inexpensive. I think it's like around $5, or maybe a bit more, not more than 10. And it's not the highest of quality, but it will do us just fine. But yeah, I like around 40 degrees, which it looks like it is exactly, so that's cool. Okay, so it didn't take too long at all, just about exactly 6 minutes, and we're all the way through. So you can see we have the bevel, the face, I mean. And now we can just continue and sharpen it a little bit more to get to a higher grit. I don't remember exactly what the grit of this stone, but this is a very hard stone, which is somewhat important. The grit is around 8,000, maybe. It can be also 6,000, 3,000, whatnot. I think it would be okay. So, to establish the heel is super simple. What I do is I do actually two bevels, one that goes all the way along the groove, and another tiny one in the end. That is the actual important one. The first bevel is more to get the metal away, like to not interrupt the metal, if you know what I'm saying. So go at it like this, lift it up around 15 to 20 degrees and do a few strokes. So this is 3 millimeters, all right? Just so you know, if you want to do the same. So 3 millimeter steel, I rest it, and I do somewhere around here. And I just touch the stone a little bit, not much, until I get a tiny nice bevel. Do the other side. Okay, so let's see if we've done a pretty good job with this. I think it's pretty decent. I probably would do a few more tweaking to it. But I think that we should do it. Okay, so like I said, for the second onglette graver, I'm gonna use some spring steel, which we are going to heat treat. But first I need to anneal it because it comes hardened, so we can shape it nicely. The first shaping that I'm going to do is I'm going to establish a flat on top, and the flat I like to do it diagonal, so the chisel goes smaller and smaller. I feel like it gives more drives the power better or something like that. All these mumbo jumbos, but yeah. That should be enough. Now I'm gonna move on to make the face, and now we can use the file, so it will be, okay, that's hot, so it will be a lot faster. Again, it doesn't need to be super accurate because we're gonna use the honing guide later on, but just to get roughly, I do something like so. Wait, why not this? This one? Again, 40 degrees. Okay. Now we have a huge burr, so we can get rid of that. Yeah, let's move on to the sides. And this, well, if you have a slightly more accurate method to do this, then do it. But for me, just doing it by eye works pretty well. And yeah, so like you've seen before, we want to keep it round, but coming to a point. So. Let's do this. Okay, I think the profile is ready to go. So, we are ready to harden the blade. And this is pretty simple. I have some water and a torch. You can literally use a crème brûlée torch. It will be strong enough to do that. And you need to heat it to around 1450, 475 degrees Fahrenheit. You can use a magnet to check it. I think the metal stops being magnetic at around 1425 degrees Fahrenheit. But or just get it. And just get it to cherry red, which is in the color of cherries. So there's not too much to do to go wrong here, so let's just do it. You know what? I will turn off the light so I can see better the color. Alright, take a file. That's the unhardened or semi-hardened because I didn't anneal it here. And as you can hear, it's nice and glistening. And before I do anything, I will slightly sand it so I can expose the metal from the oxidation and temper it. Okay, now we're gonna draw the temper, which is literally just hit it at the base, and we're gonna draw the color up to the to the tip. It's very important not to overheat the tip, because then you will obviously ruin it. And what we want is somewhat of a straw color. So we let the heat climb up, and that should be good. Okay, I've noticed that I've hit a problem with the honing guide. The problem is that when I put it in, the screw wants to push it sideways, therefore the face becomes crooked. So we're not gonna use the honing guide. Instead, we're just gonna use our fingers as a gauge. This is slightly more difficult, but it's definitely good enough for what we are doing. So the way I do it is I try to keep the engraver straight, and I use my fingers as kind of a reference point, so I keep the engraver straight. This will get your fingers very dirty, but that's what we're all about here. So yeah. That. All right, so I have the wood that I want to make for the handle, and I'm gonna go to a friend of mine that he has a lathe, and we're gonna turn them to nice pieces. All right, so we're back, and we're nearly there. We just need to cut them off, put some finish on, try to fix this mess here and fit the ferrules, and we should be golden. And see how they go. I wanted the. So before I go and start testing out the gravers and start engraving, I want to show a little bit of how I design my scroll work and how I go about it. I always begin by drawing the backbone first. This sounds obvious, but it's quite important and crucial to get the backbone nice and rounded and not symmetrical, but this will really affect the whole design of the scroll. After that, I begin to draw the inner leaves. And so the most important key element about them is that they have to kind of originate in this tiny curly thing in the beginning of the scroll. And they start to curve away from the backbone, making a really nice three-dimensional shape in a way. And that's basically what will make the leaf look pretty and the skull work come together and look nice and solid looking. Now, as you can see, I'm moving on to the outer leaves. They're pretty straightforward. They're also important that they are stayed consistent with their curvature. But other than that, you can experiment and do other crazy stuff. What works aesthetically would probably work. It's only aesthetic, so obviously it will work with that. But yeah, that's basically it. And now I'm ready to just refine the lines and make them more clearer. And we can move on from that. Okay, so now I'm ready to move on to the actual engraving. And I've retraced the artwork on Illustrator, and then I just printed it in many different sizes so I can decide which one fits the metal. Thank you. So the first few cuts with the new graver weren't that smooth, and the graver needed a little bit of adjusting to get it just right. But at the end, I got the graver to a pretty solid condition where it works pretty nicely. Moving on to the shading portion, I'm switching to the Engraving graver, which has a much finer line and basically gets the whole scroll work really to pop up and look more three-dimensional and nicely looking. So the scroll is somewhat finished at this point, so I'm put some color on it just to see how it looks and how it turned out. I will after that also remove a little bit of the background to get just a nicer contrast, but that's basically the gist of it, and that's all there is to it. Alright my friends, thank you very much for watching this video. I had a lot of fun doing this, and I hope you learned a thing or two from this video. It was somewhat simple beginner stuff, since I am quite an amateur myself. I just stabbed myself, I probably should. Alright, so I am quite an amateur myself, and I have a lot of learning to do, and so to refine my lines and get the curves curvier, and I hope it was a quite a nice video for you guys, and I will see you again in the next video, where I will do something a little bit more fun and crazy, and I will see you there in the next video.